Welcome to the step-by-step tutorial on how to load data into Enterprise Planning Cloud. You can load data into Enterprise Planning Cloud using data management for complex data mappings, REST APIs and EPM Automate, lifecycle management for artifact snapshots, or the import data feature within Planning and Budgeting Cloud. In this tutorial, we'll use this method. Before you begin, create a data file for each artifact that you want to import. You can work with the provided templates or create your own file. If you work with templates, you can download them. Then you specify the data to load. Your data file must be formatted and saved as a CSV or text file using valid delimiters. Here's an example. The import file must contain a header record, and then below the header record, a list of data records that you want to import or modify. In Enterprise Planning Cloud, you can import data using files stored locally or on the cloud server. When importing with a file stored locally, you run the process immediately. When you select to import from the server, you can save your job selections, run the import process now, or schedule it to run at a later time. We'll cover both options in this tutorial. Each business process has its own set of templates. The templates are generated based on the features you've enabled and the custom dimensions that you added when you enabled features. Let's download templates for the financials business process. On the configure page, select the business process for which you want to download templates. Then from the actions menu, select the download templates option. I'll save the zip file locally so I can extract the CSV files. You use the same process to download templates for the other business processes. I'll also download templates for the workforce business process. Let's take a look at one of the templates we downloaded. We can load expense data for the financials business process with this template. I'll specify the appropriate dimension members for each record of data I'm loading. I added some additional rows of data. Remember to format and save the data file as a CSV or text file using valid delimiters. Let's take a look at the available templates for the workforce business process. We can use the earnings, benefits, and taxes rates template to import rates for additional earnings, benefits, and taxes into the benefits and taxes wizard. There are other templates we can use to import workforce data. These include templates for importing tax properties, employee compensation data and employee properties, and salary data. The prefix in the workforce template name reflects the configured granularity, in this case, employee and job. After you've created your import files, you can import your data. I'll navigate to the import data page. I'll show you how to import from a locally stored data file. Source types depend on how your data file is structured. You can use planning or S-based data files. Then, select the file delimiter used in your data file. For more information, visit cloud.oracle.com and refer to the Other Supported Delimiter Characters section in the Oracle Planning and Budgeting Cloud documentation. Next, browse and select your data file. You can import and modify metadata the same time you import data. Clearing this option prevents members from changing positions in the outline during the import process. If you do not select this option, you must make sure the required metadata already exists in the application prior to running the import process. The date drop-down list allows you to select the date format used in your file. As a precaution, always validate your data files before running the import process. You check the status of the validation process in Job Scheduler. If errors are found, you can modify the file and revalidate it. When the validation displays as completed with no errors, return to the Import Data page and re-enter your selections. When ready, click Import. The import process takes a moment once the job is submitted. Return to Job Scheduler and check the job status. Data was successfully imported. Next, I'll show you how to import using a data file from the server. Navigate to the Inbox/Outbox Explorer, then upload your data file. After confirming that your data file is now on the server, return to the Import Data page. You must first create a job to import files stored on the server. For location, make sure you select Inbox. Select your source type and file type. Then enter the name of your file. This should match the name of the file you uploaded. Select whether you want to include metadata modifications during the import process, and select your date format. Review your selections and save the job. Your job is ready to run. Let's go to Job Scheduler. To initiate the import process, schedule a job. Select Import Data from the available job types. You can choose to run the job now or schedule it to run at a later time. When you schedule a job, you can set it to recur based on a calendar pattern. You can also set an end date for the job. I'll run the import process now. From the list of available jobs, select the job you created and continue. Review your selections, then click Finish to start the import process. In Job Scheduler, click Refresh to display the updated status of a job. After the data import process finishes successfully, the job status displays as completed. You can view detailed information when you click the job name. In this tutorial, you saw how to load data into Enterprise Planning Cloud. To learn more, visit cloud.oracle.com.